Welcome back friends, this is Ram here and it's 15th tutorial on JavaFX 8. In this tutorial we are going to see login form using SQLite database connection. So let's start with the or continue with the previous example, in that we have created a SQL connection. So in this I'm going to use some code from the tutorial 10. So that was login form validation. There we have created a transparent stage and a rectangular background. So I'm going to copy that and paste into a our login form database for SQLite connection, where we have created this for a transparent stage. We have created a layout, group layout, and a scene with 320 by 112 dimensions. We have created a foreground, a background color for the scene with the opacity 0.9. this will be RGB. Then we have taken a rectangular background of 320 by 112 of same scene size, and I'm going to delete this. So this is the 15th tutorial on database connection. For these are the parameters for the rectangle, or you can refer a tutorial 10. Next I am going to create a VBox equals to new VBox with a spacing of 5 and fix the import for a VBox. Next I'm going to set the padding for a VBox element, so VBox dot set padding and say new inset, and the top 10 comma right 0 comma bottom 0 and bottom 0 and left 10 semicolon. Next and fix the import for inset and add JavaFX geometry inset. Next I'm going to add a label, so label equals to new label, fix the import for a label, add JavaFX scene control label and OK. Then set the text field for a label, so label dot set text field, and say text field is I'm going to add color dot say white smoke. Then I'm going to add font for the label, so label dot set font and say new font of say sans serif, and font size say 20. So next is fix the import for a font. Sorry, the wrong import is added. Once again, fix the import for a font with JavaFX scene text font. Now next, I'm going to add a text field for a user name. Say username equals to new text field. And fix the import for a text field. JavaFX scene control text field. Then I'm going to add the font for text field. So username dot set font. I'm going to say font dot font and add. I'm going to add sans serif again, sans serif, comma font size say 20. Then I'm going to add a prompt text for a text field. So username dot set prompt text. So set prompt text password. Now next I'm going to add a button. So button equals to new button. And I'm going to say a button of login. Now next, fix the import for a button. JavaFX scene control button, okay. Now I'm going to set the font for the button. So button dot set font. And I'm going to copy the font of this text field. So and make it 15. And we have forgotten to add password field. So password field, say password equals to new password field. And fix the import for a password field. Next, set the font for a password field. So password dot set font. Again I'm going to copy this font of text field and set to password. Next is I'm going to add a prompt text for password field too. So password dot set prompt text and add password. So next I'm going to add a button action for a login. So button dot set on action. I'm going to use a lambda expression. So and add, I'm going to add a try catch block. So try catch with exception E1. And in a try catch block, I'm going to import username and password from database which we have created in the last tutorial. So we have created in the last tutorial user database with a user database table. In that we have added one user. I have added by my name Ram Alapure and username and password is Ram. So I'm going to import this username and password into the application and going to login through that. So next I'm going to add a string of, I'm going to fire a query for the SQL. So in that I'm going to select star means all from database. So I'm going to say user database, this will be the table name. So I'm going to select all from user database table where user name is question mark and password is question mark and semicolon. I'm going to copy, that is select username and password from the database. Then next I'm going to add a prepare statement. So before that I'm going to declare it in a application. So prepare statement PST equals to null and semicolon and fix the import for a prepared statement. So it will add prepared statement in, so it will add a import of Java SQL prepared statement. Next I'm going to add a result set. So result set RS is equals to say null, and once again fix the import for result set. Now come to our program. So in that I'm going to send a query through prepare statement. So PST dot prepare PST equals to connection dot prepare statement query. Next I'm going to import a username and password. So PST dot set string, say index 1, and next is I'm going to add username, get the username field. So username dot get text. So I'm going to import the username from database. Next I'm going to import save to and in this time I'm going to import a password. So password dot get text. Next I'm going to execute the query. So rs dot execute, sorry, rs is equal to pst dot execute the query semicolon. Then next I'm going to check if username and password is correct or not. So if rs dot next, if rs dot next, it will check the row whether the username typed in text field and password is matches with the database, and if it matches with the database we are going to print on label set text, and we are going to print a login successful. Next, else if username and password is wrong, then we are going to print a label dot set text login failed. So login failed. Now next I'm going to close the connection. So pst dot close and rs dot close. Next, for a catch block I'm going to set that if any exception, SQL exception, I'm going to print SQL error. So set text SQL error, and I'm going to print the error. So system dot error dot print a line, and I'm going to add E1 exception. So next add these elements, children elements, into the VBox. So VBox dot get children elements and add all. So I'm going to add label comma username comma password comma button. Next add this VBox to the VBox and background to the root element. So root dot get children dot add all and background comma VBox semicolon. Now we have done with the code. Before that, I'm going to set primary stage dot set scene. So I'm going to add a scene we have created for the group layout and save this and run. There is some problem of the layouts. I'm going to close this. So set this rectangle of say 250 and scene also a 250. Save this and there is a one more problem here. So I'm going to set here a user name, so it will show username and this will show the password. Save again and run. So again there is a one more problem of label. We have not added any label name, so add label in the label field. So and run once again. So this is our login form from SQL database application. This is the label field. So this is the label field, then next text field, then password field and a login button. I'm going to check whether it is working or not by giving a wrong username and password. So I'm going to set random password and check for it. When I check for login, so there is an SQL error in the program. I'm going to close this. And the error is in the string. So make it select and save this again and run. So it will print connection successful. Then I'm going to try for a wrong password, any random password, and login. So it's working now and printed a login field because I have written a wrong password. So when I print a right password, it will give a login successful as we have set on a label. So it will print login successful when you type a right password and username, and when you give a wrong password and username, so it will print a login field. Now I'm going to create one more user. So to create one more user, I'm going to add another username, say Tom. Michael, say xyz@gmail.com, then say username Tom and password also Tom. So I'm going to create a user Tom Michael and add it to the your table. So the user Tom is added in your database. So I'm going to logging through this new user. So you can give any username like Tom, or you can add your email ID as a username, or you can set your nickname also a username. So next I'm going to check for Tom. So username of Tom is Tom and password also Tom. So Tom and login. So as it is previously successfully shown, so I'm going to add a wrong password. So login of Tom is failed. Now I'm going to check for correct password. So Tom and password of Tom is Tom. So login with this, and hence the login of Tom is successful. So this is the tutorial on JavaFX 8 about SQLite database login. In the next tutorial we are going to see how to add a CSS, that is cascaded style sheet, in the JavaFX application with the same example. And if you have any question about this tutorial, ask me in a comment section, or you can mail me on alapuriram@gmail.com. And thanks for watching this video, and if you really like my work, please like, share and subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next tutorial.